Hey there. This weekend we are at the Warrenton Astoria Seaside KOA. We're in Warrenton, Oregon, which is about as far north in Oregon as you can get and still be in the state of Oregon. So the word for this campground is activities. They have so many activities. It's a little bit overwhelming, actually. So we'll talk about the activities, but let's talk about the first of all. I think this might be the largest KOA we've ever stayed at, with the exception of possibly San Antonio. There are well over 300 campsites. There's about 80 cabins. This place is huge. It's kind of like its own little town while you're in here. It is Saturday evening right now, and this place is jam-packed. It's in May on a weekend, and this place is completely full. And a few things we've noticed about the campground, and I don't know if it's always like this or just happens to be this weekend, but there's a lot of local people that come in large groups, and so you're going to have tons and tons and tons of kids running around all the time. And depending on what you're looking for in a campground, that can be a really great thing, or maybe not so much. So as far as activities go, they have the kids' fun zone with a jumping pillow, swings, volleyball court, the great big chess board, the great big checkers board, a playground, an RC car track, putt-putt. They also on the grounds have a BMX bike track. So if you bring RC cars, you bring bicycles, any kind of activity you want to do, they have here. They have an indoor pool and an outdoor pool. I can't really give you any kind of a review on either of those because they're both closed right now because of COVID. They have activities all the time. They have the train that goes around that picks up kids. They have the pedal cars that you can rent, $10 an hour. It's actually pretty reasonable, I think. They have bicycles of every size you can imagine, four-person pedal cars, two-person pedal cars, all of that kind of stuff that you can rent. Behind me is the cafe, so you can get pizza and ice cream. I think there might be burgers over there. I'm not sure when that's open, but today is Saturday and it's been open all day. So here in a couple hours, they're getting ready to do a talent show out on the stage. They had crafting for the kids. So like I said, activities upon activities upon activities. So if you're looking for a place for you and your family to be active, this is the place to be. Now, if you're looking for a quiet weekend of camping with just your family, probably not the place to be, especially in this area where we are. We are in site number 372. We are right across from the Kids Fun Zone. There are some areas up in the 100s that are much more quiet. It's not where all of these activities are going on, but back here, just plan on kids and families running around everywhere. So let's talk about the cell service. We have Verizon, and I'm getting about 2 bars. So it's pretty good, 2 to 3 bars. It's pretty decent on cell service. The Wi-Fi, I think most of the time is probably pretty good. However, when the campground is full, I think there's just too many people pulling from it. Right now at 5-6 o'clock on a Saturday evening with a full campground, I have a really, really hard time using the Wi-Fi. When I get up to work at 5 a.m. and everybody is still asleep, the Wi-Fi works beautifully and I have no problems and I'm able to stream. So I think that it's really good Wi-Fi, just too many people pulling from it. Our site, we have a pull-through site and it's very level. It's gravel. All of the roads are gravel with grass around. The location is really good. We went into Astoria today and we're only about 7-8 miles from Astoria, right across the street from Fort Stevens State Park, which is a beautiful park to go in. And you can ride your bike, really. It's a little over a mile to the beach. And so just in this immediate area, there's quite a few things to do. In fact, they give a huge pamphlet here of all of the things to do here at the campground and in the immediate area. So if you're looking for things to do in an area, this is really a great place to be. They have laundry facilities in a couple of places around the campground, so that's really great. It's a little bit more expensive than what we've paid for laundry in other places. It's $2.75 to wash, and then you pay per minute to dry. We paid about $1.50, I think, for a load to dry. The store, when you come in, is one of the most impressive KOA or camp stores in general that I've ever seen. They have everything. Kind of all of the groceries you would find at a convenience mart, drinks, all that kind of stuff, just then games and toys and t-shirts for the area, all kinds of stuff. It's probably one of the biggest camp stores I've ever seen. We paid about $65 a night, and that is for full hookup. That's only 30 amp full hookup pull-through site. And they right now, because the pool is closed for COVID, they are waiving their resort fee. I don't know how much that resort fee is, so under any other circumstances, it might be a little bit more than that. And that $65 that we paid is with our 10% discount for being KOA members. So overall, I think this is really a great campground. Again, it's going to depend on what you're looking for. It was a little bit of a shock to us because we haven't been around in a campground with this many people in a long time. We've been doing a lot of more quiet, private type places. So this is just a lot of activity in a weekend. And our location is right next to the kids' area. Depending on what you're looking for, it really is a great campground, and I think that the value is really good. At $65 for a full hookup and all of these activities, I think that it's really a pretty good value. And if you're a Goonies fan, everything Goonies is all around us. You can go to Astoria and see the house and the museum and all of the fun things, so that's really great. But I would definitely come back here. I think it's a good campground.